So the gut microbiome is fascinating. The research in this field has been evolving and showing that changes to the microbes that are in our GI tract, whether that be from the foods we eat to the medications that we take or other factors, can not only influence our overall health, but also change our risk for developing certain diseases. Everything from obesity to diabetes to rheumatoid arthritis to cardiovascular disease, even anxiety, depression, and yes, even eye disease. And interestingly, as eye doctors, we've in fact known that there was some connection between the gut and the eye for some time, as people who have inflammatory bowel disease also have a risk of developing a severe form of inflammation in the eye called a uveitis. But now research is finally starting to connect the dots between our diets, our gut health, and the risk for certain eye diseases, including that of dry eye disease, diabetic retinopathy, macular degeneration, among others. So today, we're going to be talking about how gut health and the gut microbiome can affect the eyes. Plus, we'll share some practical steps to improve both, including foods that you can eat and probiotics, all of that. But first, quickly, what is the gut microbiome and how does it affect us? Well, the gut microbiome is essentially a group of trillions of microorganisms, including bacteria, viruses, fungi, and other microorganisms that line our digestive tract. And research has only recently started to understand the ratios of these microorganisms and how they can signal and communicate to different parts of our body. And they're finding that not only do they play a major role in digestion and the absorption of nutrients, but also in signaling our immune system, in helping change our mood, our cognition, and controlling inflammation throughout our entire body. So now knowing this, how can the gut microbiome specifically affect the eyes? Well, one major theory is that the ratios of these different microorganisms, if one becomes overgrown too high or another one becomes too low and starts to die off, which we call gut dysbiosis, that this imbalance can signal different inflammatory or immune cells, which can travel all the way up to the eye and sometimes cause a stronger inflammatory reaction, which can often begin or accelerate disease. Another theory that you may have heard of is something called leaky gut. A lot of the microbes in our digestive tract actually play a positive role in strengthening the lining of our gut to prevent any sort of pathogens from breaking through and causing an infection. But if you have this dysbiosis and the healthy microbes are dying off, then the lining to your gut may be exposed. And then the pathogens or toxins from those pathogens may be able to break through into the epithelium of your gut and then into your bloodstream, which they may be able to pass throughout your body and getting to organs like the eye. One thing I'll add about this is that this is still considered a theory, as there's really no strong evidence to support it yet, at least in the eye care research. But they have also found that gut dysbiosis can also affect the absorption of certain nutrients, things like folic acid and vitamin B12. And many eye diseases require proper nutrients because the eye, especially the retina, is one of the most highly metabolic tissues in the entire body. So having gut dysbiosis may strongly affect your ability to get healthy nutrients to the eye, and that may also accelerate disease. Now, I've been digging into the research, and I have found publications that link gut dysbiosis to various eye diseases, one of which is that of dry eye disease, which happens to be something that I specialize more in. They find that people who have autoimmune-related dry eye disease, specifically that of Sjogren's syndrome, have different gut microbiomes than people who have dry eye from just other environmental reasons, which may suggest that gut microbiomes in these people may be signaling different molecules that can end up going to the lacrimal gland and making their dry eye worse. There's also several publications looking at retinal diseases, specifically that of diabetic retinopathy and macular degeneration, finding that people with gut dysbiosis or an overgrowth of some families of bacteria tend to have a higher risk of developing these retinal conditions. Some publications even go as far as suggesting that this may be the reason why some people with diabetes may be at higher risk of developing diabetic retinopathy or bleeding within the eye than some other people with diabetes. There are also other publications that look at other eye diseases, things like uveitis, arterial occlusions, or strokes within the eye, and even some on myopia. Yeah, I've even been able to find publications showing an association between the gut microbiome and nearsightedness development. I still think there needs to be a lot more research on this, but I do find it very interesting. All right, so at this point, hopefully you agree with me that this is all very interesting, but you might also be asking, yeah, but what can we do about it? Is there any foods we can eat? Is there a probiotic that you can take? What can help? Now, while I am not a gastroenterologist nor a dietitian, from what I've read in the eye care research, here's some information that may be able to help. As far as a specific diet that can help, the vast majority of research still supports that a stronger adherence to a Mediterranean diet is the best at preventing developing eye disease. In one study, looking at patients with dry eye disease, they found that the people who had a stronger adherence to the Mediterranean diet and consumed more fish and vegetables in their diet had a less of a risk of having an autoimmune-related dry eye disease, such as Sjogren's syndrome. It's also been found that diets with high fat, high sugar, and low fiber have a higher risk of developing gut dysbiosis that could lead to not only obesity, but also breakdown of the intestinal lining. Now, we also have the topic of probiotics and prebiotics. If you're not really sure the difference is, a probiotic is a food source or even a supplement that contains a live culture in it. For foods, think of like yogurt or fresh sauerkraut or kimchi, for example. Or for prebiotics, if you've never heard of that, a prebiotic is a foodstuff that helps supply nutrients to feed the already good, healthy bacteria in your gut. This may be examples of kind of fibrous foods, things like whole grains, fruits, vegetables, berries, those sort of things. I'll actually include some links in the description below that go to a larger list of these types of foods. As far as research on probiotic supplements for the eyes, I could find some studies, but only done on mice. But they do show some positive benefits for at least dry eye disease as well as uveitis. But the issue that a lot of doctors and researchers have with probiotics is that there are literally trillions upon trillions of different microbes in the gut. And it's tough for us to know exactly which family of microbes is either having a hard time or is maybe overgrown. And so it's difficult to know exactly which ones are going to be beneficial in a probiotic. Also, the issue of how that probiotic is made, because even if you're taking a supplement, if it's not made in a way that can survive through the stomach acid, then it's not going to be a live culture by the time it even gets to your GI tract. So there's also issues with absorption and effectiveness that way. So instead, I personally focus more on consuming prebiotics to help support the already healthy, good bacteria that's in my gut. Now, I have had several people reach out and ask if I have a favorite gut health supplement. And right now, the only prebiotic that I really have trust in comes from 38Terra, which was designed by Dr. Bill Bolshewicz, who happens to be a famous gastroenterologist and gut health expert. I've been testing it out for a few weeks and have been having positive results. So if this is something you want to try out, then I did reach out to them and got a 10% discount code, which I'll put on the screen, as well as put links to in the description below if you want to check it out. This channel is not about selling anything. It's all about providing education, but I also want to provide resources for you if it's something you want to try. From here, I'd love to hear from you. Have you ever changed your diet? Have you changed or eliminated certain foods from your diet and noticed a change to your gut health and any changes to things like your eyes or your skin or other things going on in your body? I think that'd be really interesting to hear from. Otherwise, if you have interest in nutrition about certain foods or supplements to optimize your eye health, then I have done a live stream going over that exact topic, and I'll put that up over here to the side. Otherwise, I want to say thank you so much for watching. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in that next video.